In this video, I am going to show you exactly how to set up a custom workflow that will automate backlinking for you using make.com and ChatGPT, as well as help a reporter out. I'm going to be giving you everything, including the blueprint. You don't have to worry about a thing. In this video, I'm going to be doing Tiny Home Hub. I'm going to set this up for Tiny Home Hub. So the first thing we need to do is we need to go to help a reporter, and we need to press I'm a source right here. We now need to make an account. So it does say here, sources may not require backlink swaps in exchange for the use of their pitch. So what I want you to know is that you can see here, it says you cannot use it solely to acquire backlinks without contributing meaningfully. Quid pro quo backlink requirements or farming grounds may be immediate removal for HARO. What you have to do is you cannot say to someone, you know, I will only give you a backlink if you give me a backlink. What you need to do is you need to encourage people to link to your website, okay? So instead of saying it's required or whatever it might be, basically just say, you know, can you put a link to my website? You don't say you have to put a link, okay? So we're going to press sign up right here, and we're just going to work through this together. So Hamish, Davison, and then you need to have an email for your website, okay? If you don't know how to do that, if you followed my guide on how to start a website, then you probably used Hostinger. If you didn't, then I don't know how to help you, I'm afraid. But Hostinger does have completely free mail, which is run by Titan Mail. So basically what you want to do is you want to press on emails right here, and you want to go to your whatever one you want to work on and press manage, okay? And then you just want to add the email. If you followed my guide, you will have an email ready to go. If you didn't follow my guide, then you'll have to work this out for yourselves, basically, okay? And then you press email accounts, and you create a new email account, and you put your name. Do not put info or whatever it might be. You have to have your name or someone's name in the business, okay? So we'll put Hamish at tinyhomehub.io. I'm just going to make up a phone number. So we'll just make one up. And then we will put United Kingdom, because that's where I'm from. Company, Tiny Home Hub, and password. Obviously, I'm not going to tell you that. And then I'm not a robot, and then press sign up. That should work. There shouldn't be any problems here that I can see. Okay. We've sent you a confirmation email with your login credentials. Check your email and sign in. So let's press login here, and then we'll click here, and we will view access webmail right here. And we should have our login details right here. Obviously, you should know your own password to your own email account. Again, I can't help you with that. Let's update the password here. And inbox, there is nothing. Okay, so it's not arriving just yet. So what I'm going to do after I press login, let's just try and jig it by clicking email address right here, and then resend validation email. We really, really want this to arrive, and you know, these kinds of services, sometimes they are kind of crap, so it might take some time to arrive, so we'll have to wait. Okay, so the email finally arrived, and then just click the activation right here, which will bring you to this video, this page right here. Let's click on update and add details. Now, this is where the first part of this comes into play, okay? So we need make.com right now, so let's go to make. Let's log in. I'm pretty sure all of this is free. I don't think we're using any premium modules. I don't know how many you can do per month on the free plan, but it's definitely still going to be worth it. Okay. So I am personally paying for Make. You can pay for it if you want, or you can just do it for free. Okay. I have spent quite a lot of money today. Doesn't matter. So I'm going to show you everything. So what you want to do is you want to press create a new scenario right here. Then you want to press these three buttons right here and press import blueprint, press choose file, and then go to my description to get this file right here, and then press save. This is everything you need to automate your backlinking process. What you want to do is you want to click on where it says webhooks, okay? And you want to create a new webhook and just call it whatever you want. So HARO Automator, press save. This will give you an email right here. You want to copy this email address, and you want to go back over to your HARO account, and you want to change the email address to this right here. Make sure you write this down, okay? Because this is now going to be your login to HARO, just so you know. Now you can put the rest of these details in if you want, but the most important thing is ticking any of these that are relevant to your niche. Okay, so lifestyle, business. To be honest with you, you can put as many as you want because we're going to be automating the process anyway. You can put all of this or you can put none of this, completely up to you, and then press save. Now, the other thing you're going to need is an asset folder. So I'm going to go on my asset folder right here, assets for HARO, and I'm going to open this, which is links for HARO responses. So this is my LinkedIn profile and this is links to my website. Obviously, you can just put a couple of links that you're planning on focusing on, so your homepage and a few important pages on your website, and then just a picture of myself. These are vital to HARO, okay? So make sure that you are always including this drive link. And in order to get that, make a Google Drive folder. So click on new folder, create the folder, assets for HARO, then press these three buttons right here. And you wanna press share and share again. And then just make sure it says anyone with link right here and then copy link, okay? And then what you want to do is you actually want to put that inside this one right here. So click the ChatGPT logo here, and then where my drive link is, put your drive link, okay? And then press okay. Now, what actually happens is every single day, HARO will send out an email that looks like this, okay? Everything is already set up for you. You don't have to do anything. Yeah, I mean, you can change the prompts and things if you want, or you can just leave them as they are. But basically, what it does is HARO sends one of these emails, sends several of these emails every single day. And what I have done is I've set up a filter here, and this is where the important stuff is, okay? Anything you want to change is right here. So click this filter, and then these are the words that I personally am looking for. So fashion, and fashion with a capital F, okay? If you want to add more, what you have to do is you have to, or change, you, first of all, you can change these to whatever you want. So you could put, think of a niche, camping, okay, for example. And now it will only take HARO queries that have the word camping in with a capital C, and then you'd put non-capital C right here. Let's say you want to add more. What you'd have to do is, first of all, this is a negative one, does not contain. You will always have to add this at the end, okay? But if you want to add more keywords, press the X here and then press add or rule right here. And let's say you want to add tents, for example, and then you want to change this to contains. Oh, sorry, you want to put this value contains tents. So now it will be looking for anything with capital C camping, okay? Little C camping, capital T tents, and then we'll do just, you know, to show you value and then small tents, okay? You always want to add the and rule at the end, which you want to write index in capital letters, and then you want to write does not contain, sorry, value does not contain index, okay? The reason for that is because that cuts off a lot of the HARO email that's not relevant. So this section here is completely cut out, okay? Because it's not necessary, we don't need it, etc., etc. So what this now does is it reads a query, it looks for the word camping with a big C, camping with a little C, tents with a big C, tents with a little C, and then if it has it, it will pass it on to the next part of the flow, okay? Which is this part right here. This part right here collects everything, and then this is where you change your prompt. So open the ChatGPT prompt. You can write whatever you want here. This is my example. You can write it however you want. However you want to build a backlink, you write it however you want, okay? And then here it just says write a response to the media inquiry value, which is 7, which is this one right here. And then we press okay, okay? This might be a little bit complicated, but you can just copy and paste me. It doesn't really matter. You don't really have to fully understand it. This last part here is a little bit complicated, but what this does, and I'm really proud of myself for working this out, is it takes the email that you have to send the email to. So the way HARO works is each individual query has a unique string email. So this one is query FQ5P. This one is query FQGM, okay? So if you want to reply to this one right here, all you have to do is write an email to this address right here. and that will arrive in the inbox of the person who sent the query, okay? And if you want to send it to this one, you send it to this one instead, okay? Now, as a test in my email right here, so it depends what you want to do. If you want to test it, then just write your email here, okay? This will send this to my email, incomestreamserver@gmail.com. If you want to use this for real, you see where it says text parser right here, just click email, and this will send it to the correct email address. But because I don't really want to send it for real right now, I'm just going to put incomestreamserver@gmail.com. Now, I haven't fully tested this. Like I said, in the thumbnail, it says use at your own risk, okay? That's completely true. I haven't fully tested this to see whether it sends the email directly to the correct pitch, but I'm 99.99% sure that it does. If someone wants to test this for me, please do. Now, the subject of the email, I've just written HARO pitch and then put the date. You can actually put whatever you want here. If you want to be clickbait, you could write something like quick question or something like that, which works really, really well. Or you can just do what I did and put HARO pitch and then now, okay? And then we've got the output here, and that's how it all works, basically, okay? So let us test this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this webhook right here. I'm going to take this email right here, and I'm going to send this email. So I have an example right here, and we're going to send this email, okay? That's a little bit confusing, but there you go. And this is like I showed you before, it's an example. So let's do Control F, make sure camping is written somewhere in this. It doesn't seem to be, which is kind of weird. There we go. Category camping and answer the camping following question. Just ignore that because we're just doing it as an example. So I'm gonna press invia, which in Italian means send. And then we are going to run this once. Let me just make sure that everything's set up. So this is going to Income Stream Surfer. So run once, and this will go through everything, and it should send an email to Income Stream Surfer with a decent response to the question. Let's see how it does first time round. Let's hope. Okay, let's go to IncomeStreamSurfer@gmail.com and open it up. As you can see, there it is. The only problem with how it's written at the moment is that it's written like they emailed me first, okay? So this is something I would change personally. I would make it more obvious that it's us emailing them kind of in a cold way. And you can see as well that this is not the best pitch because it's talking about credit cards, okay? But you can see that what it did was it picked up the specific one that mentioned camping, and it sent a relevant, or as relevant as possible, email to IncomeStreamSurfer@gmail.com. But if you make the change right here, where instead of IncomeStreamSurfer@gmail.com, you click email right here, this will build backlinks for you passively. It's not going to work 100% of the time. It doesn't work amazingly with every niche, but everything in this video that I showed you, except the OpenAI calls, are free. No one else will show you this kind of stuff. No one else will give you the blueprint without making you, you know, join their course or whatever it might be. I'm going to give you everything. Thank you for watching. I really hope this helps, and I'll see you very, very soon with some more content. Peace out.